Hey, what's up guys, this is SUB13, and in today's video we are going to upgrade our shocks. Original ones were perfectly fine up until that point where they lost their rebound functionality completely, and the ride quality reduced significantly. Starting by disassembling the swing arms, make sure your Allen keys are all the way in, because there's a lot of paint in the sockets and it's really easy to slip and damage the bolts. Once you're all the way in, prepare for a battle. Factory assemblers use way too much Loctite on these bolts and it is very hard to unscrew them. Luckily, I had to install my front motor by myself, so I didn't have to fight much to disassemble it again. Once I removed all the bolts and the axle nut, I've tried to pry it open with a little lock. It is a very stiff and tight fit, but nothing a hammer can't handle. And I'll remind you again, it will be stiff and hard to remove most of the parts. It is supposed to be like that. Just make sure your nuts and bolts are out of their sockets. And you can use a hammer and an Allen key or basically anything to reach the inside of the swing arms to push it outwards. If you want to work extra carefully, you can apply a piece of cloth on the tip of the Allen key to reduce the paint damage. Now, once the old chock is out, I will put a new one by the same steps. Note that it will be hard to align certain bolts with the swing arm due to the heavy motor, but hang in there. One of the issues I've had assembling it back is the shock bushings misplaced and it wouldn't let me push the swing arm in. But then I just loosened the bolts and put the bushing in its place. Here is a great example of using too much Loctite on its axles. I couldn't unscrew it, so I had to apply some heat to make it easier. And there's basically no differences in between assembling and disassembling front and rear swing arms. So we'll run through this quickly. Right, now that I'm finished, it is time to test it. Most likely you won't see much difference because it's very hard to show on the video, but I'll try to explain it my best. First of all, I did regain my rebound back. Second would be a stiffer feeling compared to the stock ones. My weight is 84 kilograms and I would recommend to only get the 2000 lbs version of these because anything less than that would be too flexible. Here's another stupid video I've made that will tell you nothing about the shock performance. But I will tell you that the feeling riding around the city, going over bumps and leaning at high speeds feels so much better now. But to be honest, I would get a 2500 or 700 lbs version because I would like it to be even stiffer than it is right now. But unfortunately, I couldn't find any. So if any of you guys seen anything like that online, please leave the link in the comments. I will be glad to try this out. Anyway, I think I'm done here. I was Sub13. Peace.